Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome back to a brand new video and a brand new edition of AGP Unboxed. Today I have for you a giant black box. No, I'm sort of only kidding. Actually, it is a black box. But if you look at in the light, just a little bit there, you can see that it says Black Anchor Heavy Industries. So Black Anchor Heavy Industries is kind of like the side project that Privateer Press has been doing for a few months now, where they produce these, I almost want to say like one-off pieces, but they're really, I mean, they're really meant to be used with War Machine and Hordes, but the pieces they produce through this Black Anchor Heavy Industries line are so unique and different. They really, it'd be tough to actually sell them as part of the War Machine and Hordes lineup alone. And so they've kind of got this little side project thing going, but they are meant to be used in those games. What I have here before you is called Skarre, Admiral of the Black Fleet. This is an amazing miniature, and fortunately I had a coupon that I was able to utilize when this was released, and I was able to get it for a significant discount. And so I said, you know what, I'm going to go ahead and do it, even though I don't normally buy things direct from manufacturers or direct from distributors. I normally go through my wholesaler, but this is a fantastic kit, and I'm really, really looking forward to getting into it. So I will open the box and show you what is inside. So truth be told, this is an unboxing that I've already done one time. About a month and a half ago, maybe 2 months, I can't quite remember when it was, I actually did an unboxing of this particular kit. Unfortunately, about 15 minutes into their video, I realized that I was missing some components because I was trying to kind of pseudo-assemble it as I went, and there was something very, very wrong, and it finally hit me that, yes, there were definitely pieces missing. I actually had to pull my phone out and start looking at everything that I had versus the details that were in the finished model, and I was definitely missing some stuff. But fortunately, I took a picture of what was on my table and sent it over to Privateer Press. They were very kind and got back to me very, very quickly with the missing components. I have them now in the box. That would be this component, and this component. And so I'm ready to do an actual real unboxing here. So kudos to Privateer Press for their speediness in getting me the missing pieces. Let's jump into the box. But first of all, let me know what you think about this setup. I've done a couple of videos like this so far. I'm in the process of changing over all of my stuff to this sort of overhead setup. I think it's a much more conducive setup to letting you guys see exactly what's going on. Kind of doing that over-the-shoulder angle is okay, except when I'm painting. And when I'm painting, it comes in kind of from this side, and so you don't really get a direct shot of what the brush is doing. And so I'm switching over to this sort of directly over what I'm working on angle, and I think it's going to work a lot better. But let me know what you guys think down in the comment section. Let's jump into Skarre, Admiral of the Black Fleet and this awesome kit. So first of all, we have a blister pack of metal components, which we'll get to in a few moments. We have the three components that I was missing earlier. I'll set those to the side. And you have this massive, massive hunk of resin right here. I mean, this is a single solid piece. This is definitely not hollow. But this, you can see, is a portion of a ship, which is very, very cool. And then you have the base of the miniature, which is this really awesome wave of, like, spirits and ghost faces and skulls and stuff kind of rising up out of the water. You have a massive base. I have no idea what size this thing is. If I had to guess, it's probably 120 millimeters. No, it's probably bigger than that. Maybe 150. I don't know. Anyway, huge, huge base. Just absolutely bonkers how big this thing is. And then we have a bag of components. So let me get this out of the way, and we'll kind of go over how this thing goes together and what it looks like, because it is an amazing, amazing kit. Okay, so we have some deck pieces here. We've got this really cool door right here. Some extra pieces for the ship, some cannons, some a mast right here that's kind of broken off. Let's take a moment real quick and take a look at some of the detail here. So I'm just going to zoom in. Let me zoom in on the back of this door piece right here, because this is really awesome looking. So it's going to take me a while to zoom in. Normally, my camera is much closer in than this. But very, very, very cool looking piece right here. I'll zoom. Let me see here. Tell you what I'll do is let me bring up the focus here, and we'll change it to where I can actually focus. Poke. Let's just change it to auto. There we go. All right. Done. All right. Very, very, very cool. Look at that. Look at the detail in the wood grain right there. I mean, you can see the knots and everything. Really, really nice. The detail in the skull, all these little, just the little chips and things in the horns. Really just beautiful. Take another look at this other piece over here. Look at that. Look at all the little rivets. I mean, just absolutely amazing, even down to like little bitty barnacles that are on the sides of this ship. Absolutely gorgeous. And then all the broken off pieces right there, just beautiful, sort of this dry rot or wet rot, I guess, kind of appearance to them. Little starfish back there for your enjoyment. Very, very, very cool. And then you have simple stuff like this cannon right here. I mean, simple, smooth. They've even bored out the end a little bit, so you don't have to do that yourself if you don't want to. Of course, me, I'll probably go in there with a much deeper bore, but pretty dadgum cool. Take a look at this broken mast piece right here. Again, the wood grain detailing on this stuff is amazing. And then these broken off points right here gives you those tree striations, which is really, really nice. The rings of the tree in there. Beautiful stuff. And you've got this this piece of decking right here. I love the fact that this is latticed right here, and you could actually drill through it with a pen vise if you wanted to, because they seem to line up pretty dadgum good on both the top and the bottom. They may be slightly off, but I think they're almost straight through, and you could sort of, you know, drill through that and have a look into the lower decking area if you wanted to. This is, everything's keyed very, very nicely. So you have this this mast right here, and obviously it's got this big chunk of flash on the bottom of it, but it would technically go right there into that slot with this little peg there. So very, very simple assembly as far as being able to decide where stuff goes. Let's take a look at the main piece right here. Look at this. I mean, just the amazing detail work on these windows around this main cabin area. Absolutely gorgeous. I mean, it's very repetitive. I will say that. I mean, you don't have a lot of varied detail. Every section looks exactly the same, but the detail that is in here is just bonkers. I mean, absolutely nuts. It is so cool. But let's take a look at how this actually goes. So here, I'll tell you what, let me show you the wave first. See all those really amazing skulls and everything? Very, very, very cool. This sort of ethereal wave coming up with the beginnings of these ghosts and things gliding through it and culminating in an actual wave form with all of these beautiful faces in here. Very, very cool. And you've got, again, a piece of the mast right here, which is kind of cool because the way this works is this piece right here slips into this square. So this square here fits in here. And essentially, this mast piece right here continues up into this mast piece on the very top of this thing. So if I were to sort of kind of halfway assemble it, which I can't because you've got these big chunks of resin right here. I mean, it's going to take a lot of cleanup to get this thing seaworthy, so to speak. But kind of like that, and then you see the mast kind of comes up from the center right there. Just absolutely amazing work. And then let's see what else we have here. So we have this bottom piece here, which is interesting because I didn't have this before, and I assume that it just sort of fits in maybe like so. I'm not quite sure how this goes, to be honest with you. That's the one of the bad things about this kit is that there are no assembly instructions, and so it's kind of a pain in the butt. But that's okay. It's not that big of a deal. I tell you what we can do. Make it easy. All right, so let me do this. I'll show you. This is what we call being prepared, or not being prepared. Okay, so this thing kind of fits together like this. These are like little side pieces that go underneath this thing. Let me zoom back up some, or out some. So we get a better shot of this. Okay, so to give you an idea of scale, where's a paint bottle here? Here's a jar of bolt gun metal. Okay, so that gives you a rough idea of scale. There is the height of this thing. There is the width of this thing. So this thing is 1, 2, 3, about 4 Citadel paint color jars long, and about 2 tall once you add in this piece up here, just on this one little piece right here. But anyway, you add this piece underneath here, and then obviously you would have the corresponding piece on the other side. You would have the deck right below here, so this kind of fits in here, like so. And obviously, again, none of this is going to fit together because it's got all of this flashing all over it. But underneath here, I believe, yes, in fact, I can see it right there, you actually have a nice little slot onto which this base fits. And so what you end up with is this crest of the wave kind of poking out from behind this lower deck right here, so it sort of comes out the front of the miniature. Very, very cool. I'll throw up a picture real quick of the finished product that Privateer Press originally put on their website right there. Very, very awesome looking miniature. Now, you've got a couple of extra pieces. Again, these are the pieces I didn't have before. This is a real nice just piece of decking right here that sort of slides to the very back where this, it's not really a door. I keep calling it a door, but it's not really a door. It's just a piece of decorative who knows what. Does it go that way? No, it has to go this way. All right, so it slides down in there somehow. I guess once I cut all the flashing off and everything, it'll probably go down there in there a lot easier than what it's doing now. But that's actually quite nice because it gives you this nice piece of detail on the back of the ship, which you don't really... I mean, yes, you've got a lot of small details and things like that. But as I said, it's kind of... it's very repetitive. So this is a nice little breakup of those pieces. Very, very cool. Let's take a look at some of the metal components now. Let me move some of this resin out of the way. Dear goodness, this is going to take a long time to put together and get painted. But boy, how exciting and how rewarding it will be once it's done. So, we're going to pop this puppy open. Look, there's a bunch of critters. And so here we have, I believe, Skarre herself. Okay, it would help if I zoomed in some. There we go. Okay. Very cool looking piece. Like that one a lot. All right. She's obviously missing a leg. I'm assuming... well, there's several leg options here. I'm not quite sure which one is hers. Well, there's two legs. So this one's probably hers because it's more fancy looking. That kind of has that sort of action-y dynamic to it. And it sort of puts her bottom feet-wise on the same footing or on the same plane, so I think that's probably the correct leg. Pretty cool, though. And then you have this other chick here who also is missing a leg. I'm assuming that this other leg here is hers. Yep, that would be a right leg or a left leg, so that works properly there. Very cool. And you can see I'm holding her by a horn. All of these pirates are, strangely enough, have horns, which is a little bit weird. But that's okay. You know what? I'm okay with that, I guess. Even Skarre herself has this curving ram's horn right here. And this next pirate lady here, very, very cool looking. And all of them have these really nice, like, tattered cloaks that they've got. Very, very cool. I mean, just amazing looking detail and everything. See quite a bit of flashing there. I mean, quite a bit for a metal miniature. I haven't seen that in many, many years. Early Reaper miniatures had that kind of stuff on them, but I haven't seen that kind of flashing in a while. Probably just a weird cast. Nothing major, though. Should come off very easily and quickly. And then you've got a couple of some rail pieces that also go onto the ship. You have the helm itself. That's kind of cool. So overall, amazing kit. I mean, just absolutely beautiful, and really, really looking forward to getting into this thing and painting it up. Boy, it's going to be a lot of fun. Let's see, does this fit without being... yeah, look at that. There we go. So that kind of mostly fits in there. I'll probably have to widen that hole or shrink this key a little bit down, but that's not that big of a deal. Boy, that is just so amazing. I mean, this is going to be a ton of fun to paint. I'm really looking forward to it and just looking forward to getting it finished. That is, it's going to be an amazing miniature. It's going to be a heavy as heck miniature, too. I mean, this thing is, I would bet you if I had to guess, this one piece probably weighs at least a pound and a half. This piece is probably another half pound. So all of it together, you add all the metal pieces in as well, you're probably looking about 2.5 to 3 pounds worth of miniature just in one model. This is a massive, massive beast of a miniature, but it's one I highly recommend because it is gorgeous. And I think you guys are going to have as much fun putting this thing together and painting it as I'm going to have. As I make progress on this thing, once I do get started, I will definitely let you guys see it. For right now, though, I think we'll call it a video. I hope that you guys have enjoyed this unboxing of this Skarre Admiral of the Black Fleet miniature from the Black Anchor Heavy Industries line over at Privateer Press. If you have any comments or questions about this unboxing, or anything else for that matter, feel free to leave them down in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions and hit that bell so you get notified every single time a new video gets posted. Also, please be sure to check out my Patreon page. Every little bit of support that comes in really helps me out, and I would greatly, greatly appreciate it if you would head over to that Patreon page and just take a look around. There's a lot of really cool reward levels. You can get some great miniatures that you wouldn't ordinarily pick up. You can get some great how to paint DVDs that I have. Just a ton of stuff is available. Check it out. Again, the link of that is down there in the video description. It's my Patreon page. Please, please consider becoming a patron today. Thank you again for watching. God bless you all, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.